I think they're the best. I would follow these guys anywhere. We don't do much. We just sit there and watch them. They're a pleasure to coach, pleasure to work with. They don't give you any trouble. You know, just they're yes sir, no sir. Their leadership is incredible. They lead by example. This guy here is the hardest working guy in the weight room on the ice. He's a hair faster than Kizel. I think all of them, there's such great camaraderie. The bus ride home last night from the Blue Jackets game was so much fun. Even the coaches were just laughing at their antics. They're loosey-goosey, and they're the best. They're the best kids of all time.
And throughout the tournament, going back to, you know, the Cleveland Cup and the sectionals and the playoffs, you've had so much balanced scoring. You know, every night it's a different guy stepping up. What does that say about the depth of your team?
I mean, we can always count on three or four lines to go. Like, if the first line needs a break, I mean, we can always send the second or third line out there. We're not just relying on one guy scoring. It's just spread around. Like, we never have to rely on one guy. So, I mean, it's kind of nice that we can just always rely on different guys to score goals.
I think it makes it hard for other teams to shut us down, too, because you can't just focus on one guy and shadow him or something like that. That's a recipe for disaster because so many guys can score. Even some of our defensemen can score. But you're right. I was thinking that same thing a couple days ago. It's like three different guys one night, three different guys the next night. So I think that keeps the kids, it keeps them in the game too, because they know they can always contribute. They might not be there tonight to score, but they can, you know, make a hit or make a pass or block a shot. So it was truly a team effort, and I could not be prouder of these guys.